Hello, kittens. Cat's Owl out here. And I'm playing West of Loathing. If you don't know what it is, I only know a little bit about the game. But basically, it looks fun. So, let's start. I'm disabling flashing lights for a friend of mine, and also everyone out there who watches who has problems with flashing lights, so there we go. Let us begin. I want to be a girl. I'm going to be Ada. Okay, let's just jump in and let's play. Jane Masterson, we're ready to get going. Are you? Yeah. Hell yeah, I am. I had the strangest dream. I was choosing a character class. Okay, are we gonna be a cowpuncher, a bean slinger, or a snake oiler? Couch puncher seems fun. But I could be a bean slinger. I'm gonna be a bean slinger. Magic and cooking are inextricably intertwined in Loathing, and the bean slinger is the mystical master of both. You've heard there's a shortage of cooks out west since the cows came home, due to most of the cooks having been brutally killed by the cows. Okay, we'll read each class. Okay, cowpunchers solve their problems with their fists, whether it's shaking them at a disagreeable fella in a disreputable saloon, or using them to punch a slightly more disagreeable feller in a slightly less reputable saloon. You've heard that the cowpunchers are in demand out west since the cows came home, which stands to reason. The cows aren't gonna punch themselves after all. Or, snake oilers rely on their moxie and chutzpah to tame snakes, their fearlessness to extract potential oils from those snakes, and their cleverness and manufacture and sell potions made from these oils. Oilers are doing really well out west since the cows came home. Everybody needs potions help in these days. I'm not gonna be a snowcoat, I'm gonna be a bean slinger. I'm the bean slinger. WASD. This weird poster appeared one night. Here one night. Okay. Goodbye, bed. Time to head west to chase my real dreams. You read the spine of one of your books, Jean Swift and the Secret of Monster Poison. Sorry, prison. Dad gave me this one when I was a kid. The Adventure at the Spooky Forest. Rufus liked this one as much as I did. Johnny Danger and the Incident at the Eerie Castle. Sorry. I read that 110 times. Wow, let's read it again. Escape from the Dark Forest. Clint Hardy and the Curse of Monster Church. Oh, hey. This one might come in handy. Walking Stupid. Oh. You pull the needle away from the cylinder and stow the handle away. Oh. So quiet. Hey, Russell. How you doing? Caw. We're just gonna use the buttons. How about that? I'm gonna miss you, buddy. Caw. Caw, caw. Feed, Russell. Russell, a cricket. Let's do it. Grab a cricket from your cricket bag and feed it to Russell. He coos appreciatively and nuzzles your hand. Goodbye, Russell. Be good. Maybe it's time for you to leave, too. You open your bedroom window, not pictured, and unlatch the door to Russell's cage. He winks at you, caws one last time, then flies away to the west. It's time to hit the trail. Goodbye, Russell. I can't stand it. It's too freaking quiet. There we go. Comb hair. Can I do it again? I got XP. Character? Inventory? And options. Let's go. Fucking stupid. Read it. You read the book from cover to cover and learn how to walk. Really stupid. Stupid walking has been added to your options menu. You got a perk. Stupid walking. You accidentally drop the book and then ruin it by stepping on it 30 times while you're trying to pick it up. Well. Great. Stupid walking. Okay. Let's turn it on. Yes. I already knew about this perk, by the way. I'm sorry. Keep reading! Okay. Let's see. Character. I don't have a lot of anything. Sorry, guys. Okay. Jesus. Nothing on the hat rack today. Okay, I'm just gonna... I'm sorry, I'm turning stupid walking off. I can't handle it. Stack the firewood. I gained some EXP. There we go. Progress towards next skill level up. This hearth really puts the hearth in hearth and home. Hearth. You're gonna miss mom's cooking. It's mom's pie safe. It keeps all her pies safe. You'll miss meals with the family. My brother's room. You pick up one of your brother's weird books and flip through it. Arithmetica. Just the title page gives you a headache. God. You pick up one and flip through it. Solutio problematis and geometrian situs pertinentes. None of it makes a lick of sense. Look inside. I got a Rubik's Cube. Hey, he loves this stuff. You got a Rubik's Cube. Fiddle with it. Oh, nice. Your brother already had it most of the way solved, but you figured it out the last couple moves. Damn, I'm smart. You've already solved it, and if you mess it up again, it'll be messed up forever. Oh, yeah. So tidy. Okay. No time to screw around in the woods. Time to head west. Your mom smiles warmly as you approach. I'm leaving now. We're gonna miss you, kiddo. I'm not giving them voices. I'm sorry. I changed my mind instantly. I'm gonna give them voices. Okay. We're gonna miss you, kiddo. Oh, and before you leave, I got you a present.
A present?
Yep. It's the book you wanted for Crimbo. I know it's early, but...
The one about
picking locks? Oh boy. The one about desert survival? Oh boy. The one about bartering? Oh boy.
Picking locks or bartering?
I don't care about desert survival. Desert survival, who needs that?
Bartering or picking locks?
I'm gonna go with the one about picking locks. Oh boy, that's the one. Enjoy it.
Locks and how to pick 'em.
Please be careful, oh dear. Write us a letter when you can.
I will, Mom. Goodbye. She hugged me already.
I thank you very much.
I guess I can just press. Read it. Nice. After you've done reading it, you donate it to a local orphanage. Soon those orphans will be able to make their escape. Nice. Your father morosely jabs at the haystack. The hat doesn't fit you, Dad. Time for me to leave. The hat doesn't fit you, Dad. I'll grow into it. Okay. It's time for me to leave. His lip quivers a little.
Listen. I want you to have this. Your grandmother's favorite can of beans.
You got an item. Can of infinite beans. Thanks, Dad.
Good luck out there. Be sure to say goodbye to your mother.
Thanks, Dad. Take care. Let's dig through the haystack. Hey, a needle. I got a needle in the haystack.
It's not for sewing.
It's for picking locks.
Can of infinite beans. You'd think a can with an unlimited number of beans in it would be really exciting. But these beans are pretty terrible. It is a pretty cool thing to carry around, though. This item goes in your offhand. Nice. One spell damage. This bonus makes your spells do more damage. One muscle. And one moxie. I'll read them for myself.
Skip. And my brother. Your brother Rufus is standing here looking nervous. He's pretty good at looking nervous. Give him his puzzle back.
You hand him the puzzle, and he starts fidgeting with it. Say goodbye. Hey, Rufus. Time for me to head west. I still don't understand why you're leaving. He's got a point, you know. Why are you going west anyway? To help people. To seek my fortune. To get off this stupid farm. To help people. You've read the papers, Rufus. The people out west are terrible. The people out west are in terrible. You know, like, they're in trouble.
I'm sorry, it says trouble. Oh my god. Just cut it out. Just cut it out.
Cut it out, please.
But it's so dangerous. 60% of the people who go west get killed within a year. And that statistic is from before the cows came home. I'll be okay. You worry about taking care of Mom and Dad. I'll worry about me.
Okay. If you say so. I still think you'll be dead by Crimbo.
I'll miss you, Rufus.
Okay. You give him a playful punch in the arm. Is there... He's busy drawing pictures in the dust. He's just barely holding it together. It's probably best for him. if you just go. What about Mother? Your mom raises her eyebrow. I just wanted one more hug before I leave. She smiles and hugs you again. Alright. Go west, young woman? Yeah. West of Loathing. Directed by Zach Johnson. I'm probably gonna skip this or casually talk over it constantly, so it's not copyrighted. Not that it matters, I'm not getting paid, but you know, whatever. You can read them. Oh, and look at me, I'm punching the radishes. By the way, guys, I'm planning on getting myself a camera so I can, you can see me playing the game, and I'll probably look awkward and weird, but I said, you know what, if I reach 10 subscribers, let's make a subscriber goal, you know what I mean? I'll probably get one regardless, but why not? Let's make a goal. 10 subscribers and I'll get a camera. There we go. How you feel about that? Put a thumbs up if you like that idea. How about that? Anyway, back to the game. Well, the bad news is that you fell off the cart, off that cart, and got knocked out for a couple of hours. And now you've got no ride, no meat, and no prospects. The good news is that you're in a town, rather than in a gulch somewhere. Not much of a town. Get up and dust yourself off. I got a dusty turnip. Can't you? Okay. Aw, dang, nabbit. It's a chunk of wood from the broken hitching post. Cool. Increase your muscle mysticality and moxie by 1 for the rest of the day. Interesting. 3-4 damage. Nice. A sign on the door reads, "Gone drinking." Oh. Sheriff. Howdy, stranger. Welcome to Boring Springs. I'm the sheriff in these parts. The what? He sighs. The sheriff, okay? Blasted sign painters. Say, you wouldn't happen to be looking for work, would ya? As a matter of fact, I am. Great, because I happen to have some. There's a gang of hoodlums round here. What caused them themselves the Fricker Gang? Last time I arrested one of them, they busted him out and took my cell door with him. It ain't much good without the door. And I need somebody tough, smart, and or slick to go fetch it back for me. Why don't you do it? You're the sheriff, after all. I gotta stay here and practice my chair tipping. Alright, I'll give it a shot. Funny you should say that, cause I'm sending the deputy along with you. Keep you out of trouble. He takes a pistol out of his desk and hands it to you. Deputy pistol. Deputy? You deputized a gun? You're new in town. Maybe you ain't noticed, but there ain't much to do here except drink. Here, let me write down where the Fricker Gang's hideout is for you. He makes a little note on your map. You discover a new map location, the the Fricker Gang's hideout. I got it. I'll be back with the door. Wanted, the bird thief. Naked, Mike Bernstein. Reward, 200 meat. Shit. 200 meat? Help wanted. Wanted poster artist. Apply a picture. Apply in person at the Yuma Marshal's office. Cool. Wanted. Bimmy Fricker. For face thieving. Reward? 420 meat. 420 blaze ammo. Okay, here's the Fricker gang. We can go there at some point, but right now, I'm not in for that. There's a dirty mug here. Recovered mug. A dirty glass mug. The bottom is stamped. Property of Boring Springs Saloon. Reward for if returned. You got an item. Recovery mug. Cool. Step right up. Okay, they're all gonna have the same voice mainly. Step right up, Brad's the name and trains the game. You seriously doubt that his name is Brad? Howdy, Brad. What are you trading? Well, madame, today I'm trading locks for soap and a stick of dynamite for needles. And to the cunning Skinner who brings me 3 rattlesnake hides, well, to that adventurous soul I will trade a fine silver pocket watch. I'll take the dynamite for this needle. Nah, sorry, Brad. Get lost. What the f- You approach the weird cactus man hybrid. He smiles at you. Howdy, cactus man. Howdy yourself. And the name's Bill. Cactus Bill. What happened to you, Bill? Well, to be honest, partner, I drank too much cactus beer and it turned me into a cactus. Doc Alice warned me this would happen, but I didn't listen. And that's why they call you Cactus Bill? No, that's just a coincidence. Oh, does it hurt? Does what hurt? You know, being a cactus? Oh, haha, nah, it's actually kinda nice. The natural fermentation processes inside the cactus part of me and keeps me pretty drunk most of the time. I guess it is a mite boring. Yeah, I bet. It wouldn't be so bad if I had something to read. You don't happen to have any newspaper or anything, do ya? Nah, sorry. Well, if you happen to find one, keep me in mind. Will do, Bill. Some loose dirt. Some loose dirt. We're going to the saloon. As you walk into the saloon, the crazy-eyed guy sitting to the left of the door shrieks and waves at you to get your attention. Hey, where's your hat, dang nabbit? Well, I... You can't drink in here without a hat. Tain't proper. He points to the take a hat, leave a hat box next to the door. Check out the box. You look through the hats, through the hat box, and find a magical black Stetson. That looks like something you'd wear. Grab it. You got an item. Barely enhanced hat. Nice. You grab the hat and put it on. Thanks, sir. Pete! Thanks, Pete. He gives you a friendly, if somewhat twitchy, nod. Say, gal. Yeah? You hadn't wished? If you want some company, I'd be more than happy to come along. Just let me know. Well, no pleasure. Alright, I'll keep it in mind. Crazy hat man. What'd you say, Pete?
Who, me?
Well, heck, I say all kinds of things. For instance, lily livered machines can't trust them no more than a go-dang scallywag.
Uh-huh.
Pete takes a swig of his whiskey. See you later, Pete. It's a spittoon. People spit into it. You know, without even looking in it, it's absolutely disgusting. Let's take a look inside. Yeah, it's full of spit. Regular spit, gross tobacco spit, chewing gum, and it looks like a few teeth as well. It's disgusting. And the smell. Even from a distance, it smells horrible. Look closer. You are now on your hands and knees. Yeah, I already said that. Peering into a filth-encrusted spittoon. I don't understand what is wrong with you. Wait. Is there something shiny at the bottom? Let's go for it. You reach your hand towards the spittoon. Even before you touch it, you can feel the grossness in the air, like a greasy fog enveloping the stinking brass horror. It smells like the vomit trout at a Miskit barbecue eating contest. You hesitate. Never surrender. You plunge your hand into the awful soup. It makes a sound like glop. Your skin is burning. Your eyes start to water. Search. You find your fingers make contact with something. You pull your hand out of the devil's turret. Slowly, not daring to risk splashing the contents all over yourself, you appear to have gotten some kind of ring. Probably some kind of disease as well. Congratulations! You got an item. Nasty ring. Hooray. What's the nasty ring do? One muscle, one mysticality, and one moxie. Cool. Disease. These two are playing poker, or at least trying to. They keep looking back and forth from their hands to the how to play poker card that came with their deck, biting their lips and concentrating real hard. Okay, good luck, you two. I don't have... You already have a hat. What would you do with two? I should probably leave him alone. No one glares at you. You should probably just let her drink. Howdy. I'm Jane. Howdy, Jane. I'm Lawrence. Nice to meet you. What do you do?
I'm the town hostler.
I don't know what that is. How's that working for you? Oh, those horses are just flying out the door. So business is booming? Nice. No, I mean, the horses keep running away. I haven't sold one of them in ages. Oh. Is that why you're here drinking instead? Yep. And me being in here drinking instead of watching the horses is probably how they keep escaping. It's one of those vicious circle things. Well, I'm in need of a horse. Do you have one? Have any left? One. Keep a kind of a boring one. But it's got four legs and a back to sit on. Come see me at the stable. I'll be happy to show it to you. You walk up to the bar and wait patiently for the bartender to notice you. While you're waiting, you see a sign taped to the back while reading, "Reward for lost mugs. 25 meat each. Bartender finally notices you. Howdy, cowgirl.
Howdy, barkeep.
Name's Jane. What brings you to our little backwater?
Oh, the usual. I came out west to make my fortune. Not having any much luck so far, though. Any work around these parts?
Unfortunately, Boring Springs already has more people in it than jobs. It's more of an errand town, if you catch my meaning. If you're looking for a real job, I'd recommend talking to the railroad people up by Dirtwater.
The railroad?
The Manifest Destiny Railroad Company from back east. They're trying to run a lane to Frisco and having a heck of a time doing so. And they're hiring.
Oh, I reckon they're always hiring for one thing or another. Big company, that.
Dirtwater? Dirtwater is interesting. It's far enough west that it's still more or less exempt from the rule of law, but not so far west that it's being burned to the ground by the damned cows. Lots of opportunity there. She pauses for a few seconds, lost in thought.
Yep, if I were a younger woman, I'd probably head that way myself.
You mentioned errands.
Yeah, this forsaken burg is always falling apart in one way or another. The hustler's always needing help since he hurt his leg, and that no-account sheriff could certainly stand to have somebody doing his job for him.
Anything else?
Well, I've got a goblin loose in the basement. Some cowpoke in from the clutch didn't wipe his boots off and got spores everywhere. I can probably handle a goblin.
Much obliged. I'll unlock the basement for ya.
And you'll need this. You got an item. Weak fungicide. I'll take care of it.
Wait.
I found this mug.
Who's that lady drinking whiskey out of a beer mug?
That's Susie. She's a rancher from nearby. Real tough broad. I ain't recommend you pester her.
Why's that?
Lost her whole family to a cow attack recently. Got some pent-up frustrations about it.
Ouch.
I found this mug.
Much obliged.
You hand in the recovered mug and collect your bounty. You gain 25 meat.
Thanks. You tip your hat to the bartender.
Just thought to say howdy. The bartender smiles.
Well then, mission accomplished, I reckon.
The moon glares at you.
Howdy, Susie.
Howdy, cowgirl, who's gonna be searching the spittoon for her teeth if she don't leave me in peace.
Okay, bye-bye then.
To the basement, guys.
Oh, God.
Yes, take a newspaper.
You got an item. Boring Springs Gazette, April 20th, 1995.
Nurse, whiskey brand. Good for what ails ya.
I guess we never established your age. Good thing the legal drinking age here is can reach the top of the bar.
Yeah, nice.
Attack the goblin.
Sure.
Okay.
Target whistle for 9 hot damage.
Being sealed. Cost 1 AP, usable once per fight. Increase your armor by 4. This will not end your turn. This will deal 25 damage to the target, assuming the target is a goblin. Ouch, that must have been embarrassing for you. But... There must be something I can do. Okay, I'm just gonna go around and do some things before I fight the goblin. Not because I just don't want to kill him, you know. Give him the newspaper. You give him the newspaper you found in the basement of the saloon. Much obliged, partner. Now, let's see here. What can I do to return the favor? Oh, I know. My shovel. I left it behind the outhouse at Orohoman. It's yours if you go and get it. I'm sure you'll find a use for it. Got. Yeehaw, skill up. Mr. Caldy, level 2. Yes. Behind the outhouse at Orohoman. Got it. Thanks, Bill. Don't mention it. Now, if you could just kind of stick that newspaper to my face before you leave. Okay. Orohoman. Where's that? Yuck. Miles. 1,000 meat. Wait. I'm getting so many needles. Doing quite fine, if I must say. Make your own demand. Damned guide to Boring Springs and its Inverius. Oh, damn. Thud Fricker. The Fricker Gang's intrepid lookout. Appears to be taking a little nap. I need foraging. Beer barrel cactus. It's a pile of random stuff the Fricker Gang stole. Finders keepers. Ooh, I got another mug. Okay, what about inventory? 3 needles. God, my leg is asleep. Sorry, guys. If you were fine, Sierra, sure, you might have some use for these. Okay. One of the Fricker boys is dozing off in the bathtub. Shoot him. Time. Psst. Can you pass the soap? Don't disturb him. You grab a nearby length of rope and carefully tie his hands together, and then to the handles of the tub. The sheriff can come collect him later. Just wait. I'm gonna do a quick thing. I guess I just ignore him. It's all you can do. You cautiously approach the Fricker Gang. They're pretty engrossed in their poker game, so it doesn't actually require that. that much caution. You hide behind the barrel and eavesdrop on their conversation for a while. Well, the one with the eye patch is quiet, but you gather that his name is Snipe, and that the squirrely one is his brother Wimpy. What's your play here? Approach them and talk? Leave without learning them? Howdy, boys. Deal me in. The one without the eye patch raises an eyebrow at you. Who are you? How do you get past Thud and Soapy? What do you want? You're under arrest? I'm Bimmy. I'm here for the sheriff's door. I'll show you the door. The door to hell. He reaches for his gun. Okay, then. Fight it is. Let's go for Snipey. We're gonna do this. Almost got him. Yeah. He's dead. The leaders of the frickin' gang are dead and by your hand. The sheriff will be proud of you, though you're not sure how your mother would feel. You gain 10 XP. Yeehaw! Skill up. Gumption level 2. Time to recover the sheriff's door. There's a mug on the table. Take it. A pile of the frickers' ill-gotten gains. They're mine now. And the sheriff's door. Beautiful. Thud with your boot. He slowly gets to his feet. Hey, you're not supposed to be here. That is, well, let's say he's no Rhodes scholar. If we assume that it's 7 years from now and that idiom makes sense, you feel bad about the idea of killing him. Thud, you don't want this life. Take a hike. Okay, you're probably right. Thud stumbles off into the desert. He'll probably be fine. Jeez. Thud. Welp. Yuck. Let's go receive the thing. I see the Fricker gang hasn't put a stop to your breathing. Did you rescue my cell door? He hands the sheriff his door, and he hangs it back on its hinges. Nice work, stranger. This here prison cell just got about 4 times more secure. Are there any fricker boars left for me to round up? I'll go round them up shortly, then. Looks like I owe you a reward. He produces a big bag of meat. You gain 400 meat. Got another little task for you. If you got the time, should be a lot simpler than that last one. What you need? Well, the frickers busted the lock when they took the door. Gonna need a new lock. I'll keep an eye out. Cool. Well, I'm gonna leave that there for now. After handing in all the mugs, of course. Got 50 meat. So, thanks for watching. I'll make another one soon. But I guess that's it. Leave a like, hit subscribe, and, you know, enjoy the rest of your day. Bye!